This uplifting cinematic experience.
I've got something important to tell you, Matt.
The big story is...
Dig this and dig it deep.
What if I had the power to gather all of my favorite MCs with the illest comic book characters and they became arch enemies? Inconceivable, unbelievable, yet as wild as it seems. The Emperor and Stan Lee will coach the two opposing teams. Keep it clean, no bats, no gats, guns or interference. Comic book characters would go head up with raw lyrics. Now I take whoever might be on break from doing tours and have them sign up for the last Emperor secret war. Sure, for that kind of capacity we need a crazy large arena that might stretch from West Philadelphia to East Medina. If I'm able, I'd put it on pay-per-view through my label and give free tickets to my neighborhood bums with no cable. Yeah, that sounds fat. Now that we've squared away the propositions, let's begin with the ultimate tough man competition. Set it off, it's the fight of the century. KRS and Professor X would battle each other mentally with rhymes. These two team captains waste no time. Charles Xavier tried to invade Chris Parker's mind. He shot a cerebral probe at Chris's mind, but he missed it. Professor X taken out by the Blastmaster's metaphysics. Round two, new fight, words of life, you gotta see this. Locked in Mortal Kombat, it's Doctor Strange and the genius. Yeah, son, he's no match, let that grafted wizard have it. My liquid sword slashes straight through Doctor Strange's magic. Another hero down, and now the score is 2-0. By words from the genius, and he's still my rhyming hero. Now the next fight was conducted in a rough-like manner, specifically between Reggie Noble and Dr. David Banner. Or should I say the Incredible Hulk when he's amped off the gamma? But Reggie Noble soon became the Incredible Red Man and slammed him. You know how Red Man gets when his adrenaline starts pumping. Started skitzing in the ring, so then the Thing tried to jump in. Ben Grimm leaps into the ring, and after Red Man, he lunges. But Reggie Noble dropped him with two bricks and he punches. Rhymes by the bunches, bums get dirty in the Middle Eastern dungeons. Ready to set this like Detective Columbo in his hunches. While the refs clean out the ring, cause the last fight was so intense. Let's do a live interview with a brother named Common Sense.
Yeah, it's Common Sense, a nice man. Tried to freeze me, so I took him to Chicago and told him to take it easy. He couldn't see me with my Applejack hat and high tops. Colossus and Cyclops, I got no idea why not. But look at Common Sense, yo, that last album was tight. Let me get back to the ring and evaluate the next fight. Now the next fight had to be the craziest of all times. We got Dr. Octopus
versus the mighty Buster Rhymes.
Doc Ock versus Buster, man, that stuff is dead. He'll get his eight arms ripped off going up against the Dread.
Aha, now Dr. Octopus, who you think you grabbing? The guard can never lose, so you know it will never happen. Lyrically making me sleepy, you need a nap when I slap you with my dreads. Lights out, you kiss the canvas.
Before my eyes, I see the demise of another superhero. Next up is Roscos versus Magneto. Now anything goes when Magneto battles foes. But Roscos had him shivering, delivering ultramagnetic blows. Magneto is now deceased and a wise man said it best. The sun rises in the east, but they can still set it in the west. Now with all these heroes down, Stan Lee refuses to surrender. He got scorned from the X-Men as if I couldn't match the gender. Stan Lee shouts,
Excelsior.
Yo, Stan, you best to chill.
There's no match for Storm.
I guess he's never heard of Lauryn Hill. Now we all know Storm controls the temperature and weather. Started running off at the lip and El Boog was like,
whatever.
Since she just got home from tour, she's a bit too tired to spar. So she clocked Storm over the head with my man Wyclef's guitar. All silence has ceased, out of nowhere comes the Beast versus J-Wu, the Damager, the Black Prophet from the East. Releasing rhymes that will pound you into the ground. There'll be no round two. Another victory for hip-hop by the Dirty Rotten Scoundrel. Now the underground sewer system that lies deep below the ring is where the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles and Dos Effects do their thing. Leonardo and Donatello, they well know that we can do this.
So kick it, crazy, hit them both with raw. So it.
Now Raphael and Michelangelo, those two other sewer brothers, book smacked them with the Dos Effects logo, the manhole cover. Whether you're plant or animal, vegetable or make it the mineral, before you step to Dos Effects, you best be hard like a criminal. Taking you back to ringside just when you thought it was over. The last battle was brought forth by G.I. Joe and Cobra. Mercenaries and soldiers, G.I. Joe was rolling thick. But I'll get the military of hip-hop, aka the boot camp clique. World War 3 for 98 in the wake of all these troops. I could see General Buckshot going toe-to-toe with Duke. Salute the captain for rapping, cause now we know who's hard. Catching rap like stealing tech up against the Crimson Guard. Charging after you, smashing you. Metaphorically bashing through the entire Joe team is OGC and Ruck the Irrational. Then all of a sudden I hear this real loud crack.
The military punished your big rock, just broke roadblocks back.
Adding insult to injury to Stan Lee and his team. We've got Weapon X from Canada, aka Wolverine. You know the routine, his claws can rip rappers for days.
But here comes the Method Man,
aka Johnny Blaze.
Wolverine, you can't hang when T'Challa does his thing. Paralyze you with the venom from the Method Man's fang.
This is the final battle as the stratosphere gets darker. We got Nasir Jones versus Peter Parker. Nasty Nas, the halftime headbringer, versus the web slinger. Illmatic versus Radioactive in the Rotten Apple with a deadlinger. He cursed the day that spider ever bit him. And
gave him a copy of the second LP it was written. For all up and coming MCs, I've got a question. If I made a Secret Wars Part 2, would your name even be mentioned? Would you make the final cut? I make the nicest, give their titles up. Writing rhymes slash fighting crimes like the Blue Falcon and Dino Mutt. Stick around for the next battle slash adventure. And if you see Stan Lee, tell him the last emperor sent ya. Sent ya. Sent ya.
Characters and made them arch enemies. Inconceivable, unbelievable, yet as wild as it seems. The Emperor and Stan Lee will coach the two opposing teams. What if I took my love for hip-hop and comics and made it equal and gave the people Secret Wars Part 2, the long-awaited sequel? An animated hip-hop grudge match, I'll make it lethal. How would my favorite rappers perform in the face of evil? I take the RZA from Wu-Tang, yes, the Resurrector, versus Captain America, our nation's oldest protector of Homeland Security, the top defender, top avenger. He gets dropped and injured when raw hip-hop commences.
Now it gets critical when Bobby Digital crushes Captain America. Perhaps the rest go would have to jump in it too.
But the RZA was too nimble. The Red Skull licked off shots to hit him. RZA then launches the Wu symbol into the New York skyline. Time the Red Skull gets blown apart by the Ghostface Killer alias Tony Starks,
aka Iron Man, Ghostini the scientist, the top contender. What other Wu members could I enlist? Who's next to die in this? I would take Master Killer in Golden Arms versus Power Man and Iron Fist.
Imagine Blade, the Black Hunter of Vampires, going after DMX, the dog from the Rough Riders. I mean, there's no telling how they might react. I've seen how X can bite the track. Would Blade be afraid to fight and then leave with his life intact?
Yo, Blade, I think you got me wrong. I ain't that type of cat. And if you trying to step to the dog, I'ma have to bite you back.
I saw DMX break him apart, take him apart. He played with the art. I saw X drive a stake through his heart. Another mission accomplished. X came, saw, and he conquered. Bury Blade's body in a shallow graveyard in Yonkers. Imagine after seeing X putting in work, watching the ring, you see the illest pit bull in a skirt. Reppin' the double R, the first lady from Philly, Eve, y'all, versus David Banner's Amazon cousin Cole. The She-Hulk jump in the ring and start swinging. I see punches, they're moving in and out. Two femme fatales engaged in a cage match, two woman bout. A lot of female rappers play, but not Eve. They done got Eve knocking chickens out like Layla Ali. Then I see the She-Hulk kiss the canvas. Stan Lee now gets embarrassed. So his plan is to summon Submariner from Atlantis for due to include ATL in this war.
It's foolish. I just get ludicrous to settle the score. And any bout of brawl, you're about to fall. I spit alcohol and drown Prince Namor. Actually, he's no match for me. Put him to sleep beneath the sea, and then came Thor.
Ludicrous and the mighty Thor, the battle I chose. Had Thor swinging his hammer while Chris was throwing them bows. He sent Thor back to Valhalla, made Submariner seasick. Scores a victory for hip-hop, plus the DTP click. My battle rapping is war. My raps is hardcore. Imagine a Rockefeller camp versus the Fantastic Four. As I get deep with it, Marvel Comics, street lyrics,
as we proceed with it. Jay-Z versus Reed Richards. Imagine Mr. Fantastic and Hova going at it. Jigga spits like an automatic. Click, 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 it's over, damn it. Any static from Human Torch, y'all know the procedure. Send a message to young Memphis, he'll go and defeat him. F-Easy, believe me, Johnny, calling my game out. Come with it, I spit it real cool and I'm putting your flame out. Remember Memphis, Secret Wars is a critical world where rappers disappear like a villain, the invisible girl. But let's not forget Benjamin J. Grimm. Now what kind of rapper could Rockefeller get to slay him? I mean, who would step inside the ring? Who would have the right to swing? Enough muscle and might to bring Beanie Siegel fights the thing. Imagine Beanie and Ben Grimm going spit for spit. Beanie Siegel and the Thing going brick for brick. Now what I saw was the boy get gully.
He messed around and got knocked out by the Broad Street Bully.
But yo, we got a slight problem as the Hobgoblin glides in. I see him dropping bombs on the crowd, so I'll just have to get freeway with the bump shotty. Shot him, firing, knocking him down. Ow, repping the city of Philly. Back to the ring when I'm distracted by Joey Crack. Fat Joe knocks out the Kingpin. The Kingpin thought that he could extort Don Cartagena, but not in this Terror Dome, this is Terror Squad's arena. And there's a lot of room for these rappers that I produce. Keith Murray came home in a hurry to box Dr. Doom. My miscellaneous instantaneous battle techniques will leave him scarred, courtesy of the Death Squad and LOD. Let's see the crowd's reaction from action. Turn up the lights. No doubt it's hype from all these rappers in my house tonight. But live via satellite, look who's about to fight. From the Brick City, it's the Outsiders versus Alpha Flight. The Jersey Regulators, Young Z versus Vindicator. Rod Digger took out Snowbird with words. Yes, she served and she slayed her. And later, as is in slang tongue with their pattern of rhyming. Kick back to back freestyles that took out Puck and the Shaman. The Outs tore it down like they do it on tour. Pace One punched out the side, squashed and yelled, "I declare war." Now it seems World War III is in progress. Of course the Punisher would target the leader from Onyx.
Sticky fingers, I kill rappers while holding my gat. That means I'll slam the Punisher and put a hole in his back. You know how I act. What up, try your luck, let's see. You finished, I'm in it to win it for the USG.
As you can see, there's no casualties on my team. Me versus Stan Lee is more like man versus machine. I seen Exhibit from the West flying in versus Colossus X-Man with the iron skin.
Exhibit sucker punch, the Russian could not contend, not defend.
There's no choice in my arena, it's either die or win.
This is all that happens if heroes target rappers. Then wouldn't Matt Murdock be going after Marshall Mathers? When Eminem then used the daredevil for target practice. Slim Shady maybe Ben Affleck catch wreck and then cause disaster. Somebody find a gurney, I'm a stretched and blind attorney. Bury him alive and burn him, tell D12 he tried to hurt me.
Now this certainly serves as a hideous mix when I call D12 to fight the insidious citizen. This fight music produces bumps and bruises as the Scorpion and Rhino fight Conniva and Proofin. Swifty McVeigh slays Mysterio on his illusions. Con artists gave the chameleon some minor contusions. Then I heard this loud sound, at first I thought was a bomb.
No, you idiot, it's just Bizarre versus the Blob.
They went and took the belt from a battle I felt they enjoyed. Back to the 8 Mile where it's wild and held it down for Detroit. Now as the time runs out, Stan Lee is checking the clock. There's room for one last battle, let's see if y'all feel me or not. My ultimate tag team would be like Biggie and Pop. Stan Lee would get the Black Panther to team up with Juggernaut. Biggie snatched off his helmet, threw it to a fan in the audience, turned to the crowd and said,
"Somebody should've gave that man a warning, cause I'm a forum. This is real, not a performance. I'm the voice, weed smoke, helps my endurance."
Yeah, Big, still rapping
Rolling blocks and BK, I say one of the best who was ever destined to rock. Rhymesayer and slayer of Xavier's brother Juggernaut. But now, let's not forget the Black Panther and Pop.
Holla if you hear me, superheroes is trying to kill me. The son of a panther to slam ya. Ride with me, it's Stan Lee. I'm sure you remember me, even in death. My words leave a legacy.
Hip hop titans and giants at war when they died. In the afterlife, standing together, fighting side by side. From Marvel to DC to Dark Horse to Image, bear witness to the power of hip hop. There are no limits to all worthy opponents, heroes, challengers, contenders. These are the last Emperor's Secret Wars. I'm finished.